Is it time we stopped calling our pets pets? Well, they were always going to come for the pets eventually, weren't they? Animal rights group PETA, spelled P-E-T-A, says the term is derogatory and wants us to start using words like companion and human carer instead.
The charity's calling for a ban on phrases such as bringing home the bacon, let the cat out of the bag, and take the bull by the horns.
Yeah. But a lot of people at home who have dogs and cats, they will call these animals their pets and they'll refer to themselves as owners. And this implies that the animals are a possession. Like a
oh,
car,
for God's sake. No, you don't even believe this, Gardner.
I do.
Let's cut to some of the other phrases you want to get rid of. Bring home the bacon. You want to say?
Bring home the bagels.
Bring home the bacon.
Yeah. But what happens if like you bagels? Actually want to right. bring home bacon?
Yeah. What if you like bacon? And don't like
well,
bagels.
These are, you know, these are playful expressions that are inclusive for everyone.
Why? What is wrong with
because
one-trick pony?
Language is always evolving, and we know this. Phrases that we would have used 50 years ago.
I get it. What's
ago,
wrong with one-trick pony?
Ponies aren't here to do tricks for us. They're their own individual animals.
Some ponies love doing tricks.
If we think about how we would
have you
want
asked
children
them?
To
have you asked a pony
animals?
Whether they like doing tricks?
I think you know, Piers, that ponies don't speak English, so right. that would be a waste of effort.
Weasel my way out is a problem too. Why?
Well, because that has negative connotations about weasels. That
weasels
would make you
are weasels.
Someone being sneaky.
Weasels are weasels. They are weasels. Sneaky. That's why they're called weasels.
No, it's not. It's
it
why,
is.
It's why you think they're called weasels. But
there might be bigger fish to fry.
Of course.
You can't say that. You can't say that.
Whoa! Why are you frying fish?
Yeah.
You pescetarian animal. You may remember Fartgate yesterday. Just to remind you, I showed the original Fartgate, which was the Democratic congressman from America, Eric Swalwell, who had a bit of a swellwell.
To ask the Ukrainians to help them cheat an election. And the complaint that I've heard is to ask the Ukrainians to help them cheat an election. And the complaint that I've heard...
He, of course, denied any flatulence and said it was his mug scraping, apparently, in the studio where it was going on, which seemed very unlikely.
Do you think he thought it might be silent?
I don't know. I think you can tell by the way... The point is, you can tell by the way his whole body... Even my daughter, Elise, was watching this yesterday. And she said... I showed my daughter over dinner. And she said, Daddy, look, it's so obvious. He's sucking himself in. You can, and if you go back and show it again, she's right. Look, watch him again.
Ask the Ukrainians to help him cheat an election.
Yeah.
And the complaint that I've heard is to ask the Ukrainians
watch.
To help him cheat.
Yeah,
election.
The little, and his the whole body ricochets back. I mean, that's a clear sign
it's
of guilt.
It's damning.
But anyway, the team upstairs, as always, did a mashup of ludicrous pictures of me and put them to music, the Eric Swalwell way. I haven't seen this, but apparently it's funny.
And that's why we're three share points up. Brilliant.
That is what you don't get on BBC Breakfast. And you know why? Because they can't laugh at themselves.
I like documentaries, travel programmes, and some jolly good crime thrillers, films.
Are you not a Tipping Point fan then? Maureen, this is awkward now. You haven't mentioned Tipping Point.
I don't even know what Tipping Point is.
Oh, Maureen, it's gone from bad to worse.
Political correctness is alive and well, despite the coronavirus. Fascinating incident yesterday in the Six Nations Championship, where England's Joe Marler, well, let's just say he got to grips with the Welsh captain, Alan Wynne-Jones, in a way that has caused some controversy.
It's a little tickle.
It was a little tickle.
Or it's
and
a squeeze.
All hell broke loose. I thought the whole thing was funny, right? Because I remember Vinnie Jones doing this to Paul Gascoigne.
Ouch.
And for 30 years since that picture, we've all laughed about it and all said, what fun. But of course, we now live.
Is that unnecessary?
You're feeling, was it not funny? Oh, was it a little bit, was it inappropriate? Should Vinnie have been arrested for assault on Gaza? Should he?
I'm not sure it's something we want to encourage.
No, we don't want to encourage anyone having any fun whatsoever in the entire planet. Gareth Thomas has actually had to apologise for finding that funny. This is where the world has gone. The world... the world's gone nuts. And the reason it's gone nuts is you can't laugh at Gazza and Vinny for 30 years and then suddenly...
But hang on.
..find
that's
this
not,
the worst thing ever.
You wouldn't do that here, would you, when you say we're not allowed to do that in the entire planet?
What do you
You're
think
not
rugby,
allowed to do
what
that,
What do you think
actually?
Rugby players do to each other in the scrum? He's having a laugh. Oh. It's funny.
Does the other guy think it's funny?
I think there are two. No, he didn't actually. Funnily enough, the Welsh captain, who's about 6'9" and built like a brick outhouse, he found it very serious. He hopes
there
world.
There we go. Well, hang on. World, didn't we take him seriously?
He hopes world rugby takes a look at it. Do you, Anna Wynne-Jones? Oh. Really? You've played high-level rugby for 20 years and this has really offended you?
What's Joe Marler's explanation?
Joe Marler has tweeted one thing this morning.
Right.
He's tweeted... I can't even say what he tweeted, but
was
it involves...
Chicken?
It rhymes with bullocks and he's done it twice. Bullocks, complete bullocks, and he hasn't said bullocks. He said the other word, which I can't say, at 6:51 in the morning. I think you're in... The world is now in two halves. You either can look at the Joe Marler thing and you can just have a laugh, which most normal people do.
Is or you can go
this way. Is grabbing someone's genitals actually funny in this day and age? This is Love Island. This is what millions
are
watching.
What's your favourite number?
I've got this in the bag. 11.
Mine's 11!
Oh, my goodness. It is the freshest number. Like, you know what? A number is so pure.
Yes.
Also, I love the number one, but one is just so lonely. Like, 11 is 11. Two ones. It's like two people. I love it.
11 is like two people. It's two people. One and one is two. It's one and one is... I'm amazed she knows one and one is two. I think that's a real step forward for this series.
No, one on one is
11. I'm not sure in the last series
just,
they knew.
She just pointed that out.
No, but one on its own
is
two
lonely.
People. It's two people.
But it would put it with another one.
But
it's 11.
Susanna is two people.
Yeah, but look at how
one
much
plus
of
one
a,
is two.
How much of a conversation we can have about this? So you can mock them.
Honestly,
but
I could talk about these dimwits all year. Anyway.
Good morning, dear. How are you, Piers? You're looking especially fragrant this morning.
Thank you, Judge Render. Glad you noticed.
I can imagine you've got a new perfume on. What is it, Twitter Rage or something?
It's called Tweet Delight.
It's Ode to Twit, I think, actually.
What would you do if Cristiano Ronaldo had said, you know, and the thing is, I've always just fancied older men and now's our opportunity. Would you have followed through if it was Cristiano Ronaldo?
Not with Cristiano Ronaldo, but if it was an Arsenal player and it would improve his performance, I would take one for the team. I'd have to.
Any Arsenal player, even the...
Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, and he said, look, you know, you need to do this because it'll improve my performance. That's a difficult question.
How far
do you take being a fan? Do you take one literally for the team?
Ian Wright?
I'm not quite sure how this conversation ended up in this cul-de-sac. Two wonderful guests now, though, keeping their spirits up in lockdown, are Britain's oldest identical twins. They are 95 years old, Lil and Doris.
Right, you two, I want to know one thing. Which one of you is my fan and which one isn't?
Lil.
Lil's my fan. So, Doris, I'll come to you in a moment, Lil.
Doris, you're a very sensible person.
Doris, why are you not my fan?
I still like you, Piers.
Lil, so Lil, you are my fan, so it's lovely to have you on the programme.
What would you normally be doing if you weren't in lockdown? What do you miss?
Not a lot.
OK, so perhaps I ought to ask Doris then, because Doris, you're the one who's finding it boring.
What would you like to be doing? Playing bingo? Sitting by you.
What is the secret of your two, of living so long and so well? What's the secret?
Plenty of sex and
no sex.
Is that true, Doris?
No sex, plenty of goose.
And Lil, I hear that I have a love rival, Jason Statham. You're rather fond of him.
One night with him and I'd die happy. Mind you, I'm coming on to you now.
You are? You're flirting outrageously, both of you.
Got to keep your social distance, though, remember?
We're playing a bit of music now to get you in the mood, ladies. A bit of Barry White.
I wanted to feel what it'd be like wrapped in his arms, but I think... your need is greater.
All right, you're making no sense now.
Take him. Take my Ben.
Doctor Strange. It was Ben Shephard all along!
Patty, I'm thrilled to bits. I'm very flattered as well that somebody who is discerning as Mary would feel like I can offer some sort of solace in these times of need, such uncertainty.
I just love the idea that Ben Shephard is an electric blanket for the nation in a time of crisis. I think that works brilliant. A lovely, warm snuggle.
But in the meantime, I have for you a Greg's vegan steak bake.
Right. The thing, again, nobody wanted, right? So they could...
Say nobody wanted it. When they launched their vegan sausage roll, it was one of the most popular things that they ever
people
sold.
People were queuing around the block
Here's the vegan sausage roll, which is, as I always remind people, more calories than a McDonald's cheeseburger, so it's obviously not good for you, right? And it's sold...
But people aren't eating them because they're good for you. Yeah, they're eating them because they're good for animals.
No, people are running around and go, I'm a vegan. Look at me. I'm all virtuous. Here's my little sausage roll. Why is it called a sausage roll when sausage is a meat product, right? One.
Because so you can have a vegetarian sausage.
But because I pointed out the bleeding obvious, they sold a billion sausage rolls. Now they come up with a steak... What's it called?
Steak bake.
It's not a steak.
No, it's
If you Google steak, a steak is a cut of meat or fish. It's not vegan. And they should not be using meat terminology to sell non-meat products.
To be fair, I think you have a point, because that doesn't look like steak. That looks like mince.
Well, it's not steak. That is not a steak, and that is not a sausage roll. Mm. Sausage roll has meat in it. Steaks are meat or fish products. They're not vegan, vegetarian products. Sorry? And it's a total con. You lot are all falling for it. Right, there were queues around the block at some Greggs in Newcastle.
Greggs in Newcastle.
Probably all people they'd paid to be there, right? 80% of the world's almonds are produced in California. And they're produced by the pollination from bees. They actually ship in 80% of America's bees get shipped into California every year for 4 to 5 weeks. And they pollinate to create almonds and avocados, the other favourite of our vegan and vegetarian friends. Mm. So, in the process of making almonds and avocados, literally billions of bees get exterminated, killed, wiped out. Right. These little guys, right? Yeah. Now, when you blow them up that size, they look like real animals. They are animals.
They are animals.
They are living creatures. They're animals.
They're almost like pets, aren't they?
You know what? They are as animal as any other animal.
Yeah. Min, talk us through how this all started. I mean, you're skipping... The skipping Sikh has taken the internet by storm, hasn't he?
Yeah, he has. So it all started when we were at the allotment, basically, during lockdown. And my dad loves skipping, but he obviously skips outdoors a lot more. And so he started skipping. I had my camera ready, filmed him, and then put it out on Twitter.
I think it's definitely easier to skip outside than inside, though.
The door's getting in the way.
The door's getting in the way.
Can I just say, Cammy, right now, our skipping Sikh is doing incredible physical feats. And can I just say, you two, half his age, sitting around playing football on your PS4.
By the way, Cammy is not half his age. Don't believe that for a minute, are you, Cammy?
He's so youthful, our Cammy.
Look!
Oh, hang on, slippy hands, hang on. Min,
does he ever stop, Min? Does he ever stop?
No, this is the thing. I think he's like a battery that doesn't run out. He's full of energy from early morning, say 3 o'clock in the morning when he gets up to pray, right through to, you know, late in the evening, always on the go, gardening, exercise, washes the cars, does the housework and cook. Here you go, we've got Spider-Man here.
Oh, my goodness. I can't tell you what. Min, what'd be great is if you could just have the webcam on all day, I could watch this all day. Just watch what Rajinder's up to in his house.
Cammy, you've been watching and you've been seeing just how brilliant he is. We can't have you there without doing some sort of exercise. Can you do a handstand up the wall or something? Don't let me down.
You are such a mean
Come on.
Friend.
I haven't got any trousers on.
Prove it.
Oh. No. If he said it, he means it's true. It's absolutely true. Spare... I take it back.
Can I just say, we've got 73-year-old Rajinder there, fully dressed, doing enormous performing acts there. Cammy can't even be bothered to put his trousers on.
The thing is, it won't be that you can't be bothered, it's probably that you forgot. You just forgot to put them on. That's the problem.